Hello students, welcome back again. I welcome you all on our audio-visual presentation by your teacher Sheikh Fatima. Now we are going to proceed further with our new chapter, that is drafting a virtual message. This is one of the interesting chapter because you all are familiar with the topic that we are going to study today. Drafting means to prepare or to develop. Virtual means not physically existing as such but made by software to appear to do so. For example, even I am giving you online lecture, even that is not existing, but just because of a software or certain app, it is making us easy to make a video. So this is what called virtual means. In simple term means I am not physically present in front of you, but still you can hear me and you can understand my message which I am giving through this video. It's through this virtual message. This is what it means, things which is not actually present, but because of software it is making you to imagine or to understand that the message given by the sender. Now let's see what communication is. Communication is an important or essential part of human nature. Because of communication, we the human being exchange our ideas, thoughts or information from one person to another. This is what a communication means. As the most intelligent animal on the planet, humans have derived different communication processes to express themselves and understand each other. As we are one of the most intelligent animal on the planet. As we human live in a society, we have derived different communication processes to express ourselves and to understand each other. For example, before the arrival of oral communication, that means when there were no oral communication, non-verbal was the method where we used to express each other through our gesture, facial expression and our movement. And on broad term, communication can be classified into three forms such as oral, written and virtual communication. This is oral communication where you can see a sender is sending his message and the receiver is receiving, and then later they will encode and decode their message and finally they will respond to the message given to each other. Next communication is written communication. Whenever we send a message in a written form, then that communication is known as written communication. Our next communication is virtual. You can see right in front of your screen. Students, you are very familiar with the audio video lecture. Similarly, you have been done many a times of video calling to your family or friends. Even in that, there are no people present in front of your screen, but the software or the app make it easy for you to see them. Similarly, whenever we have meeting, even in that meeting, people do not present in front of us, but the message is easily conveyed to us through internet or to the software. Now let's see what does a message means. A message is an informal mean of communication. The receiver of the message has to go through the given message and pick out the most important bits of information. That means whenever we drop a message, maybe a text message or maybe a return message, the receiver who is receiving the message has to read all the message, and out of it he has to or she has to pick up the most important information where he or she is going to reply through the message. Then he or she should be able to reproduce that information in order to convey it to the person for whom it is intended. Similarly, as I had said you before, from that information where the receiver has received the information, that receiver have to reply to the message So the important part he has to pick it up so that he can reply or she can reply to the message. In general, there are four type of message. Now we will be seeing what are the four type of messages. The very first is positive message. The positive word itself says that whenever you have a good feeling or whenever you want to thank, appreciate or express your interest, maybe if you want to show your sympathy or if you want to help anyone, this is what you show through your message, and that message is known as positive message, where you have a good feeling, where you get good vibe from that message. I would like to show you a clip which is for your information purpose. There is no mean for promotion or to promote anything. So this is taken for the reference.
To hear the world to sing in perfect harmony. I'd like to buy the world a Coke and keep it company.
Next is negative message. In a message where the message convey disappointment or disapproval or dissatisfaction, message of disapproval, disagreement or denial or refusal or cancellation, etc., then that message is a negative message. For example, if a manager disapprove your presentation, or he is dissatisfied with your performance, or maybe he disagree with your answer, or he denial your promotion, or he refuse your week off. All the negative word which come into the message, then that message is known as negative message, where it completely show a disappointment or negativity, and hence that message is known as negative message. Our next message is a neutral message. Neutral means to be neutral, not to be in a good or not to be in a negative message, where there is no feeling, no emotion, no sentiments, a dry message showing neither joy nor sorrow, message that do not draw any conclusion. I have prepared a clip for you to understand this message clearly, and there is no mean of promotion of anything. So you can go through the clip. Thank you. next our message is persuasive message. Persuasive message means convincing or impressive message. Whenever a person or the message that communicate persuasively that agreement on the writer point of view or used of convincing language or the words. So whenever the message have a convincing power, when they are trying to convince you with their point of view, then that message is a persuasive message. Here again there is a short clip for you so that you can get more clear through the information given.
सबका निखार फ्रेश है, फिर पोल्यूशन, ऑयल और कुछ ही घंटों में सबका निखार फ्रेश से चिप चिप, पर मेरा निखार अब भी फ्रेश है।
कैसे?
फेयर एंड लवली का आविष्कारी पाउडर क्रीम, इसमें है फेयरनेस क्रीम और ऑयल कंट्रोल पाउडर जो दे आपको पाउडर फ्रेश फिनिश। फेयर एंड लवली पाउडर क्रीम।
नाउ लेट्स सी इन डिटेल व्हाट इज वर्चुअल कम्युनिकेशन। Virtual communication is a mode of communication that include the use of technology, that is audio and video, to communicate with the people. For example, video calling with the people who are not physically present in front of us. To whoever we are communicating, that person can be in our next room, or maybe on another floor, or maybe they can be in our neighborhood or even miles away. But through virtual communication, we have started a way back with the invention of telephone. Through telephone, it become very easy for us to go through a virtual communication. For example, virtual communication had made a big hit through video calling or through audio video presentation. Today we use virtual communication in almost every walk of life, within family, friend, office, to name a few. Today we will learn more about virtual communication and explore why it has become one of the most popular way of communication. In addition, we will also see some preview of some of the best virtual communication tool used across the world. There are six major type of message in a virtual communication, that is directional message, message of possibility, message of reality, message of necessity, new idea message, and reframing message. This type of message we will be doing on our next lecture. So today we have learned drafting a virtual message. What does drafting a virtual message means? Next, communication and the types of communication. Next, we have also learned what is virtual communication and how it came into existence. Virtual communication came into existence through telephone, webcam, internet, etc., and this and conference call too. And through all this, virtual communication came into existence.